What we're doing is basically overlaying. The process of overlaying, or the DEM, or a grid, hydro layers, the lines that represent rivers, or roads, and the layers that we're creating as part of the CHGIS project, which are boundary layers for prefectures and point layers for administrative seats of counties, prefectures, and towns. You can use a GIS to generate a map. This is a map going out into the western provinces of China. The focus here isn't as great as it is on my machine, but this is going off in another province. We can use it to look at various kinds of historical data, in this case, a drought index for parts of North China, with red being the highest degree of drought. But the important thing to keep in mind is that in some ways a GIS, whether it's an historical GIS or not, is not a map. It is a database. And that is a crucial, crucial distinction. If you think about GIS only as maps, you're going to be misled. You want to think about them as databases, or database or databases with all different kinds of variables, all different kinds of information. And so what we want to do is take the data and we want to link it to spatial objects. Now, at some point, those spatial objects have to be drawn, right? As you see here. But the important thing is to have the data there in databases so that you can call it up and you can call up its physical representations on a map. And then use it. Here you start to see actual real CHGIS databases where we're looking at a database of counties and we're doing a query which says, show me all the counties that existed in such and such a year. That's the importance of a database. You can query it, you can get information from it, and then you can display the information you've chosen. And thus, we can get something like this. 1911, right? The provinces, the prefectures, and the counties. And notice the combination of polygons and points, polygons being the boundary of the province, the point being the provincial capital, for prefectures as well, but for counties only points. I'm going to be coming back to this in a bit, the whole question of polygons and points, about the role of boundaries in historical GIS, and our assumptions that administrative units are in fact bounded units. Another example. It allows us to take moments, different moments in time, and put them together. What we're seeing here, although I suspect it's not as clear to you as it is to me, but right up here you can see this. We're taking in black background, boundaries of prefectures in 1102, and we're comparing them to prefectures in 1550. For orientation purposes, Shanghai is right there. This is Taiwan, so we're looking at South China. And if you look here, you'll see the thin red line marking a 1550 prefectural boundary and the full black line showing it in 1102. And so what you're seeing basically is that you're seeing the points at which changes took place, right, between these two points in time. Now, that's not particularly important information perhaps, but eventually certain kinds of that information does become very important. The same thing, for example, here. Here I've compared county seats in 1085, which are in black circles, and county seats in 1550. Again, looking at the same area. And one of the things you're seeing, and one of the problems thus we have to explain, is the fact that very few county seats disappear, but county seats get added. What is the reason that counties get added to the map, so to speak? What's happened here in the 500 years that leads to that? Is it population? What is it? How do we compare that with other areas and so on?